Mary nodded, rum pa bum bum, rum pa bum bum. Then I played for him, rum pa bum bum. Me and my drum, pa 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 bum, pa 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 bum, pa 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 bum. I love you, Jesus. Everett. The holiday season was unfolding with miracles because Laurel and her mama, Black Cat Papillon, and miniature Sheltie Zorba were enjoying Christmas together with Mama's second husband, Jamaican Brooke. Muskrat and Lassie were fine too, and the family was healthy after having experienced a serious mishap in Cave Junction halfway to Medford, Oregon from Nasika Beach, which is where home was for Laurel and her family. Mama, Laurel, Zorba, and Papillon were on their way to pick up a friend named Regina from the airport in Medford. It was 1982, just before Christmas. Laurel was sharing the driving with Mama, driving through Cave Junction on a rainy late afternoon. A Cadillac ahead of them in the right side lane of the road was suddenly backing up, and Laurel put on the brakes and hoped the car ahead of them would stop backing up in the middle of the road. Suddenly, the Cherokee Chief Jeep Laurel was driving was struck from behind in a horrific crash. After the crash, Laurel drove the Jeep to a nearby gas station and talked to the driver of the lumber company truck that hit her. The truck was older, heavy metal, like from the 1950s, and it didn't even look much damaged. On the other hand, the Cherokee Chief Jeep was damaged severely in the rear. The accident left Mama and Laurel with injuries that would affect them for years and years to come. Fortunately, Zorba and Papillon did not appear to suffer from the accident, though no doubt they did do to some degree. They always got extra love thereafter. Christmas came, and Regina had to leave the Medford airport and return to Los Angeles and would see Laurel's family at a later time. The driver of the log truck company was inebriated, drunk, and he should have gone to jail, but he did not. He did a kind thing for Laurel and her troupe. He made arrangements at a local motel for them to stay the night before driving back to Nasica Beach in the morning. That night at the motel, Laurel experienced a short bout of paralysis, and it was scary to go through, but it did not last more than a half hour at most. The fact that she went through it was amazing, and Laurel knew it was a miracle that she did not remain paralyzed after the severe accident the family had been in. The Jeep was somewhat drivable, and Laurel drove it all the way back home the next day. Then the Jeep was declared totaled and not driven again. It was at this time that Laurel's family had no vehicle at all to drive or get around town in. Nasica Beach was 7 miles north of the nearest city where a store was located, a McKay's and Century Markets to shop in. Fortunately, there was a little store in Nasica Beach and cafe. Laurel and her mama came to befriend the cafe owners and their large family of about 5 grown and nearly grown daughters. Papa Joe and Mama is what we called the parents who owned the cafe. Actually, they leased the store for their cafe and made all the food they sold. The daughters helped to cook and wait tables for their family business. The cafe, small market, and a tavern was the extent of businesses that were available to Laurel and her family. The larger store selection was 7 miles south in Gold Beach and north 25 miles in Port Orford. The cities were essentially 25 miles apart because that is the distance one could travel fairly comfortably on horseback and in horse-driven buggies in times not so long ago. One day when Mama and Laurel were taking a walk on the side of the street going down Nasica Beach, they noticed an elderly gentleman driving by them. He was interesting to Mama and Laurel because he reminded them of Chief Dan George, a famous Native American who was also in some movies that they both enjoyed watching over the years. They continued to take note of the man that resembled Chief Dan George, and time and again they saw him driving along. Sometimes he drove with a lady too. Mama suggested to Laurel a proposition. "Laurel, let's go to this man's home and introduce ourselves. I think he is a good person and we should like to get to know him better." Laurel looked at her mama and said, "Mama, you are right. This man seems like a kind person that I should like to know as well." Mama and Laurel did not dash over to the gentleman's cottage near a bluff beside the sea, nestled with several other little cottages. They waited for quite some time, braved up inside their hearts, until the time seemed just right. Then Mama and Laurel decided to go right up to the gentleman's front door and knock on it to see if he was even remotely what they had presumed he would be like as a person. Winter was still going on, and the skies were cloudy and temperatures were very cold. Mama and Laurel made their way down the short gravel road towards the bluff and to the little cottage where their new friend lived, or so they anticipated to have a new friend. when they met him, if he wanted to be their friend as well. They knocked on the front door and waited, then knocked again. The front door opened, and Laurel and Mama looked closely at the person that stood in front of them. He was as old as they had imagined, and he seemed as friendly as they hoped, too. Mama said, "Hello, we are your neighbors and live just south of here. We have noticed you in the area and wanted to introduce ourselves to you." The man had a nice smile, and his eyes showed his amusement of two new visitors showing up at his front door. He asked, "Would you like to come inside and visit for a while?" Mama and Laurel said, "Yes, thank you very much. That is very kind of you." He said, "My name is Everett, and I am glad to meet you." Mama said, "I am Vivian, and this is my daughter, Laurel. It is a pleasure for us to make your acquaintance, too." Everett ushered Mama and Laurel into his very small cottage with the front door facing the north. Mama and Laurel sat down on two chairs in the living room and told Everett that he had reminded them of a person they liked very much. Everett was eager to be friends and was very friendly. Everett asked, "Would you like to look at some of my collections? I have some rock collections and photograph collections too." Mama and Laurel both said they would like to see his rock collections and photograph collections as well. Everett looked around for his collections and lovingly shared them with Mama and Laurel. Mama and Laurel thanked him for sharing the collections and said they would love to come back and visit some more, which they did. Everett was nicer than Laurel and Mama had even hoped, and he was quiet when they told him about the accident they had been through in Cave Junction being rear-ended. He asked Mama and Laurel if they ever needed a ride to just let him know, and he would take them to town with him. Everett added, "I take my neighbor and friend Isabel to town often, and you are welcome to come along too if you would like to." Mama and Laurel were elated. "We would love to come to town with you any time at all. We have not been able to shop except at this little store just north of here in Nasika Beach, where everything seems 2 to 3 times more expensive than in town. Thank you so much for the offer. We are grateful to you." Everett made arrangements with Mama and Laurel to take them into town on his next visit. Laurel and Mama were on time and very happy to get a ride into town to go shopping. Everett was a very good driver and showed them how to keep an eye on the side of the road, being observant of wildlife, especially deer, who often feed beside the road, then forget that the road is busy and cross it when it is not always safe to do so. That was one of the biggest lessons they learned from Everett. Almost every week from that day on, Everett would take Laurel and Mama into town. Sometimes Isabel would come along, but more times than not, she did not come. Everett was of slight build and seemed about 70 years old or older. He had long white hair that reached his shoulders and drove a very small 4-seater pale yellow economy car that had at least 50,000 miles times 2 or 3 on it. Everett often had shopping to do when Mama and Laurel went shopping. He would shop on his own and Mama and Laurel shopped on their own. Generally, they shopped at McKay's, the newer store that was on the western side of Highway 101. Everett did not always need or want to shop when Laurel and Mama did, but he would come to town special just for them. He never asked for a single penny to help offset the cost of gas getting to town. He was a true gentleman. He did not know that Mama and Laurel had so little funds at hand that it was a near impossibility to give him anything for his help. Mama did ask Everett, "Everett, if we can put something towards the gas for taking us to town, please let us know." Thank you. But he never asked them, not even once. Chivalry is not dead. And if Laurel ever thought for one second that it was, she knew by knowing Everett that it most certainly was not. Laurel and Mama liked visiting with Everett on the way to town. He was fine company. He didn't talk so much that it made their heads swim. He talked when he felt like it, and he had important things to say about life, politics, and God. Everett, Mama, and Laurel mostly shared their lives and talked about nature and God, friendship, and things that meant a lot to them all. Time went on, and Mama got a vehicle to transport around in over time. Laurel and Mama eventually saw less and less of Everett. Everett moved away from Nasika Beach after time too. They never saw him again, but Everett was not far from Laurel's thoughts thereafter, because his warm and genuine smile often came into her mind. Everett has been thought of and hoped for the best by Laurel thereafter. Everett could not possibly still be alive today unless he was well into his hundreds. Yet Everett's warm heart, his thoughtfulness, friendship, and love have continued in time to now and beyond now into the lives of Laurel's family and children. Laurel talks of Everett on a pretty regular basis, and after reading this story, Laurel hopes her efforts to bring good deeds to the front of people she cared very much about become important to other people as well. Being a caring and chivalrous person does not take a great deal of effort on the part of the gentleman or woman. It is rather simply ethics and morals, caring about people you come in contact with who mean something to you and your life, and people who make life a better place by simply doing what is right in their minds and their hearts, bringing community to a higher level of importance and standing, bringing back something that should never be lost in the first place, and hopefully will never be lost again.
Thank you. Bum bum. Then